Hello and welcome, this is Moose2006, and we're back once again here with our farm. So I'm going to go ahead, we're going to get started harvesting our barley. This will fill up fairly quickly, so we'll have to check on it a little more frequently than we did with the canola. So that'll be fine. It looks like I did not enable our straw swath, which we definitely want. Because now that we have the windrower, or at least now that we have this larger harvester, picking up the straw will be pretty easy compared to like the first field we harvested. So I'll probably go ahead and take the time to pick this up with the loading wagon and take it in to the our barn, kind of on the northern part of our farm, to sell it. So we'll do that once we get enough harvested to make that worthwhile. I did buy floodlights for nighttime. However, they cost about $5,500 a light, so we can't really afford any right now. They also might lag the game pretty severely, but we might give them a shot here this episode or the next. Now, I had a really good comment. Can't remember from who. I want to say Connor Wilson, but that may have been, he may have been saying some other comment. But anyway, someone said that these two trees will get me quite a bit of money, and I'm definitely fine with cutting them down, so we're going to do that. So I don't, yeah, this is fine. So let's go ahead and do just a little bit of forestry, get these two trees turned in. I also have never done a poplar. Is it poplar? Poplar? Or am I saying something that's not even... Yeah, poplar tree. And firs are what I usually do. So this will be my first of these. I assume it works the same way. I probably want to go through, cut off the branches, maybe? Oh, these... Okay, these do have large limbs. So yeah, I apologize if I ever, like, bring up your comment and I'm not able to give, like, remember the exact person. That's purely because there's this really wonderful problem of getting, like, a lot of feedback on these videos. So, that's really cool, but it is going to mean that I'll mess the names up once in a while. But anyway, this is a little finicky. Because then I had another commenter a few videos back that said... cutting off the large limbs, like if I cut off all these large limbs, even though it's kind of a hassle, it will net me more on the tree. The tree itself will sell for more because it's like a little cleaner or whatever, so I'll probably go through and cut off all the little limbs as well. But I want to, come on, shouldn't be this finicky, should it? Well, that one might just be on there. Okay, there we go. That's, wow, this is a really, really large tree. Thank goodness there's no falling damage in Farming Simulator. Not sure if I'm doing much. Huh, this is... Okay, where is, there we go. And that's connected to there. I just sometimes I have a hard time seeing where they're connected. Okay, there we go. Well, he got stuck. Okay, let's climb this again. And this one is just, I'm just cutting it off. Oh, no I'm not. Get off of there. There, it's gone forever. Good riddance. Just a few more, maybe. Okay, I'm stuck on something. That branch. There we go, one more maybe. Just this one. Ah, beautiful. What a nice looking bare tree. Now we just have to cut off all these little limbs. I'm gonna check on our, yep, Wow, it can only do about 1 1/3 strips before. Oh, yep. I do notice that the tipper is not on the back of this. I will remedy that situation right now. Get our barley. There we go. Let's go, farmer. Oh man, I think we need a new tractor. That might be our most pressing goal. Besides maybe getting a few floodlights, or at least trying them out again. I have a really pretty good computer, but I tested the floodlight before I loaded. Oh yeah, the worker is. Okay, there we go. That took entirely too long. Anyway, I tested the floodlights before I logged into this file, and it really lagged my game out for a little bit. So it must. I don't know. We'll probably try at least one or two and see. Our header is having a nice little dance over there. It's just sort of jumping up and down all on its own. 'Cause why not? And we're empty. And go hired worker. You are the best. So we're 20% full, so we'll definitely fill that up in not too long. Alright. I also had another comment, now that I'm thinking of it, that said the biogas plant can hold 900,000 units of silage, like per bunker. So it's good to know. So I think I will keep focusing on this tree and get all these little tiny branches off. If it'll let me. I may have to jump on it. Let's see there. I want to get as close to the trunk as possible, I believe. I think that makes sense, at least. And. Whoa, whoa, buddy. Okay, here we go. So, yeah, we'll probably just leave these on the ground and invest in wood chipper at some point in the not too distant future, but I think I'm pretty committed to getting a tractor. And we can sell, if we want, we can sell the one we're using now, which will get us like $20,000. But it'd also be nice to have, just get a new tractor and keep another one, so we have three of them. But we'll see what we can kind of get into. These trees will help a lot. And then the barley mission will help. And then we can do some mowing silage stuff, which can make a lot. So we're definitely set up to make. That's not a good angle. Well, none of these are really good angles, I guess. Actually, that is a good angle. Okay. I was speaking. I forgot to continue speaking, so I've forgotten what I was speaking about. So anyway. We'll just move on from that. There. There. Okay. Yeah, forestry is really nice. There's actually a really good discussion. I think Snipo Rain, pretty frequent commenter, asked what I'd like to see in the next DLC. And we kind of got into a discussion about not only the next DLC, but maybe even the next like game. Granted, this is less than a year old, so that's a ways away. But I mentioned how I really hope they continue this idea they've started of the map or like the world manipulation. How in 2013, the Farming Simulator 2013, is that going to cut? It looks like it's going to cut the entire end of my tree off, but I don't know if I can get a better angle. So in Farming Simulator 2013, the map was just 100% static. You couldn't do anything to it. And then in this one, of course, we have forestry. So now not only can we remove trees, but we can also plant trees. So it's like a super low level form of terraforming, but it's, you're able to interact with the world a little bit, and it's really nice. Like, if I want to plant more trees to line the roads, I can. You know, I can do it for purely aesthetic reasons. I was talking to one of the first couple episodes about how I want to just plant a lot of these fields with grass just so it looks nicer, and I can also do the same with trees now. And then when I want them removed, I can, of course, you know, if I don't want trees somewhere, I can remove them and sell them functionally, not just, you know, take them off the map, but actually use them in the industry. And I really hope they kind of continue that, especially I'm really big. It'd be really nice to see more of the aesthetic concept in play. I know a lot of people probably don't play Farming Sim for the aesthetics, obviously, but you know, being able to place buildings, be able to kind of lay out my own cow lot or my sheep farm or where I want it, or once it's placed, being able to move it. So that each map, you know, everyone may be playing on the same map, but their farm is going to look different. Their barns are going to be in different places. Their sheds will be in different places. Their cows and sheep will be, you know, everything will be just a little different. You know, keep the town and the city and all the elevators and things that... What is... This one is being pesky. You know, keep the towns and everything in the same place, obviously. Don't let us change that, because that wouldn't make sense. But my farm, I kind of, you know, it'd be nice to start off with like a bare map or have like a mode where you start off with money or, you know, a loan and just nothing. And it's up to you to like place your initial buildings. You still keep the mode where you just start, obviously, like this. I should probably check this again. So still keep this mode where you can just kind of start a game, because a lot of people, I'm sure most people just want that. But it'd be cool to just have nothing, like maybe just a field, and then you can decide where you want to kind of set up your buildings around that field. I don't know. It'd be kind of neat. And they've already sort of started those processes with the forestry. So it'd be cool to see those. So anyway, I guess initially I said what I want in the next DLC isn't so much of like tractors or tools or implements or anything like that. For me, that's not like a huge part of it. I would like to see more placeables, like lighting, like floodlights that I don't have to use a mod for, because I don't have a problem with mods. I think it's cool that people do them. I think it's great that we have them available. Obviously, it allows for like a lot more gameplay. But you know, if I would rather always, of course, just download like directly from Giants. Like I did the New Holland and stuff like that. So being able to have lights in an official DLC. Oop, I should probably start this. I should probably turn lights on now that I'm talking about them. So yeah, DLC of placeables like lights and sheds and just things like that. But there are mods for all that stuff. I know there's a shed mod that I may look into. And I've already downloaded the floodlight mod, so they're out there. I just need to maybe... I wasn't planning on using mods, but it's very probable that I'll continue to download some here and there, depending on our needs and desires of this game. This is a really, really, really large tree. Like, I can't see... Oh, boy. I don't know if this is going to work. I don't think my... Maybe if I halt. Okay, we want that, and we want this in. No, that's so bad. Okay, push up. Uh-oh. Oh yeah. We're gonna let go of this. I hope. Okay, it's not quite working. There we go. And we're back. So now the question is probably cutting off just a little bit at the end will probably help. I don't want to cut too much because I want a lot of money. But maybe like this ugliness right here. Is that too much? It's too much. Right here. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see how this works because then I'm going to use the end of this tree, of course, for the wood chipper later. Let's. Yeah, I'm sorry the lighting. I just always forget to turn the light on. If it's too dark, I don't know if adjusting your monitor brightness helps. Obviously, I don't want you to have to do that to watch my videos. That would be ridiculous. But if I ever forget lighting, that might work. I don't know. Because to me, it's pretty bright. Like I said last time, it's bright when I record. And then when I actually watch the video later, like when I'm rendering it, it's always a little too dark. I think I can actually drive this now. Yeah, look at that. One large tree coming up. Okay. Alright, that is money. Money, money, and we'll repay it. Just I like to do that just so the loan payments are a little smaller. We'll be getting our cow payment pretty soon, and we probably need to check. Oh, we actually need. I'll speed through the night as much as possible. You know, I was going to. I guess I'll just keep talking about the placeables thing. Since, you know, I'm just kind of working. I was about to say, like, yeah, I should have a backlight. There we go. Oh, we could buy a floodlight, couldn't we? Should we? Yes. Let's do that, and then I can talk if I feel like it. So we have brands, mods, and category mods, placeables. Buy. Oh, yeah. Borrow. We're just gonna buy one. See how it looks. See if it lights up a good amount of area. Okay, we need to rotate it this way. Should I do like the corner, like right? Because I don't want it to affect my. I don't want to affect the harvester if it's like right here. So I could do like one here. Maybe one in the middle and one down here. Yeah, we can place it and we can always sell it later. Let's do that. Right. I just don't know how much it lights up. Well, I guess we have to learn. So right there shouldn't affect any of my vehicles. Okay. Placed. Now, moment of truth. Where is it? It's over here. Okay, we'll turn it on, see how much lag it lag happens and how long. So it says space enables it. Whoa. So it's gonna lag for a bit. I think it goes away after a little while. But that is really, really nice. Huh, forgive me, but I might buy just a few more. Maybe one more for this field for now, and then one more by the forest, like where I'm doing a lot of logging, maybe? Yeah, I'm in the wrong place. That's true. And buy one more. Okay. So let's actually just put one. I probably could have done like four corners. It won't let me put one there for some reason, but anyway, we'll put one here. Right. I can probably put it in just a little more. Okay, let's go turn that on. Got a long way to run. Wow, that is really nice. I am so far very happy with that mod. Oh, and our field. We're going to slow down time again. Our field is fully grown. I actually want to turn this on before it gets too much daylight to just test it. So I probably won't buy any more floodlights until like the next evening. Here we go. Bam. Oh, that is wonderful. So we'll probably, yeah, want one more in the middle here, and then maybe another couple on the other side. Maybe? It looks like it might reach, but I can't tell how much of that is the floodlight and how much of that is like because it's almost morning. So anyway, we'll go back to... I'm not sure if I have to shut them off or if they shut off in the daytime. We'll have to kind of test that. You know, our sheep are probably done wooling. Well, no, not quite. They're well fed. Everything's good. Let's do that second tree. I might be able to do it a little faster since I have some experience now with poplars. I guess I'm not really good with tree identification. Let's cut it down. Also, thanks for the comment about this these two trees. That's definitely helpful. And then yeah, let me know about the lighting, the floodlights, where you think I should put them, if you think I should put them. Yeah. And I would really like to hear a sound, like a, like that exact sound effect. If they could just have me record that and then put it in the game, that'd be great. But yeah, like a big cracking of tree sound falling in the forest. You know, so it has that like powerful effect of like, you know, you just cut down a large, massive tree that's been aging for 100 years and you've just sort of destroyed it. Luckily in this game they're just pixels, obviously, so I don't feel too bad. But I want to hear that sound. I want to hear the crunch, but I guess we don't get that. Or maybe my volume's too low. I don't really know. I always play either with low volume when I record, or I play with 90s pop music on, so it might also be my fault. But I definitely hear the chainsaw, and I didn't hear the tree falling. Anyway, so earlier, you know, 5 minutes ago, who knows, gosh, these limbs are so finicky. Like, just cut, just go away. Go away. I was saying how, when I was hauling that tree in for the first time in this episode, maybe it'd be neat if you could, like, use the resources you gather to, like, build your... Oh, I am stuck in the tree. Okay. To build, like, the placeables, like, the house and stuff. But no, I hate that. Like, I was like about to say it, and I was like, no, that's terrible. Like, don't mention that. Or at least don't mention that as like an idea I support. Because that really would then detract away from the purpose of the game. Like, that would become then like, you know, Minecraft-y, Terraria, EE. So, yeah, like, while I still want to do placeables and stuff, I still just want the resources to just be sold like it is. Because I think the one allure, or at least for me, of Farming Sim is it's kind of like, it's got this like arcadey quality. It's like really simple, or like seemingly really simple, even though there's like tons to do. Like, kind of the aesthetic, like the visual and the gameplay is like, I don't know, it just seems very like arcadey like to me for some reason. Whereas when I play other type of Farming Sims, like, oh, why have I bought so many of them that I don't play because they're terrible? But anyway, like, I just bought, what was that one that came out like 2 weeks ago that was awful? Expert Farmer. They try to, like, play it off as, like, realism. Like, they go for more for the realism aspect, and it just doesn't translate very well. Whereas, like, Farming Sim has it figured out. Like, this is, it's the best. I mean, it's just really, really good. So anyway. Ah, I keep getting stuck inside the tree. And I can't tell if that's part of this tree. I kind of want to keep those trees there. I like... Ooh, that's... That looks nice. Anyway, I do want to keep those pines there to line this road. I guess we can start cutting like limbs and see what happens. Maybe? If I can get over there. Nope. Okay. Yep. Alright. And yeah, I'll cut this limb and then go get some more barley. Good. Whoa. Alright. And. Ah, fogs. So I do have to shut the lights off if I want them off. But we'll just leave them on. Hopefully it doesn't mess things up too much. It looks really neat in the fog. Disconnect. I know this is like a ridiculous process when I always have to disconnect the header to. But I can live with it because the header is so nice. Yeah. I'm fine with it for now. Definitely do want to upgrade, but that will be a while from now because this tractor needs to be replaced with bigger and better tractors. All right. Let's get this started. We'll go finish that tree. Okay, I'm just saying the chainsaw is cool. I don't think I've said that yet. It's fun. The chainsaw is fun. It'd be neat if like the three chainsaws had some sort of difference between them, besides just like how they look, but it's cool. It's really fun to use. That's really all I have to say about the chainsaw. I just kind of thought about how much I enjoy using it. I'm starting to like forestry a lot more now that I am getting used to it. I guess getting better at it, even though it's still a little finicky, like this. Like, I'm crouching. There we go. Maybe. All right, so let's get these limbs off. I'll probably fast forward right now into like, yeah, fast forward forestry mode. Here we go. Okay, I think we did it. I will say that a lot of you probably noticed that I cut the end of this off. That was a complete accident. I was cutting through a limb and also, and then it just sort of cut through the whole tree. So, yeah, that happened. Let's straighten this out a little bit. That should sell for more, and let's sell it and see. See if we can make some money. Or at least how much money we can make. That's probably not a very good angle. There we go. Oh man, is it too big again? I can't tell if it's too large or just stuck. Then we can cut a little more off. I don't really want to, but we're gonna, because I need to be able to pick it up. Okay. Really? I feel like it's smaller than. Uh-oh. Okay. I feel like it's glitching out a little bit. We're gonna give it one more shot. Okay, come on, front loader. You can do it. Oh, no, you can't. Really? Let's try just getting a little better grip on it, maybe? Yeah, it is. It is not wanting to budge. Oh, it's break. Oh, boy. Okay, let's. You know what? I'm gonna leave it. We'll figure that out next time. Let's fill up the barley one last time before we go. And then next time we'll probably be able to finish the harvesting, because I'll be a little more adamant about checking. And then we can get our... We might windrow it first and then get our loading wagon and fill it up with straw so that we can sell it. Oh, yep. Oh boy, that was just one of the worst displays of driving, which is really saying something when it comes to my driving. Anyway, let's fill this up. Come on, let it go. And that will be a day. So I'm gonna, yeah, we'll let it fill up. Okay, so this is gonna fill up. Thank you for watching. Of course, let me know about the floodlights, where you think they should be placed. Obviously I like to get those ideas. Have yourselves a very nice day.